learning how to make unique effects really help setting your videos apart. In this tutorial, you will build a 2-in-1 title and sliding door transition that can be extended with all kinds of features and visual effects. And this will go way beyond what the bond tool built-in transition can do. And even more, you will practice using expressions, custom tools, anim curves, and saving all this as a template. Let's get started. First, we want to thank everyone watching our videos, and if you haven't subscribed already, think about doing so. The transition that we are going to build is a great base for you to practice and develop your own features. But for all of you that also want something ready to use with a clear custom interface, we will have an advanced version available in our store in the next few days. Let's jump into DaVinci Resolve. The first thing is to add some footage to our timeline, and there's a few ways to do so. If you prefer to keep it lightweight and minimalistic, start with 2 color generators, but if you like your effects to be created on something a bit prettier, choose 2 random photos, or in this case, 2 clips that will be used as placeholders for the template. As we are building a transition, one good starting point is to add a fusion cross dissolve. In your effect library, under fusion transition, add a cross dissolve to your clips. As usual, you need to trim both clips so there's enough frames overlapping over the length of the transition. Now we can edit the transition by either doing a right click on it and choosing open in Fusion page, or by clicking the little wand in Inspector. This gives us 2 media in to work with, media in 1 and media in 2. We also have a dissolve tool inside this group that we can either delete, or better, we can replace it with a merge tool by dragging it over the cross dissolve and replacing it. This keeps our media connected to the flow, but unlike with the dissolve tool, we need the media in to be connected to the foreground. It's easy to fix by either doing a right click on the merge node and choosing swap inputs, or by pressing Ctrl T. Let's arrange the layout of our template for maximum clarity. This merge will be our output node, and I'm going to rename accordingly by pressing F2. Properly naming your nodes is a great habit and makes working on complex effects or collaborating much easier. Select media in and click on the merge icon to add our input node. I'm going to immediately rename it. So say that's our input. This node will also have another job toward the end of the tutorial. And I'm going to do the same thing for the media in 2 by adding our second input. Now, drag 2 transform tools into the nodes window and connect the input node to each of them. This will send our media in 1 image to both transform in parallel so we can manipulate it separately. And you will see in a moment how powerful this is. Let's rename them for something shorter. This one is going to be TR2. And you guessed it, TR1. Disconnect the input node from the output and add a new merge node to which we're going to connect both transform nodes and connect it to the output. Now we're going to prepare those 2 transform tools for animation. And as we want our transition to be compatible with any kind of frame rate, we are going to use anim curves. We need to extract the x-axis by creating a simple custom control. For this, right click on TR1 and choose edit controls. This is not a custom control tutorial, so I am not going to explain every options in there. That said, if you would like us to make an in-depth tutorial about all the custom controls that you can use, how and why to use them, please let us know in the comments. Name this new control X axis, press Tab, and notice how the space was removed for ID. This is very important. For type, keep number, choose controls for the page where we want it to show up in the inspector, input controls, slider control, and give a default value of 0.5. Right now, this control does nothing, but we're going to change this by doing a right click on center and choose expression. Expressions are bits of UI code that is case sensitive. This means that be very careful when you're writing them, as even just forgetting a capital letter would be enough to break it. This expression defines the coordinate for the center point, and instead of 0.5 for the x-axis, we're going to write not the name, but the ID of our new control. So in this case, x axis without space. And now I can move the transform tool along the x-axis with our new control. To reset, double click on the name. We have to do the exact same with the second transform tool. I could simply copy and paste the first one, but as I have all my connections already nicely laid out, I am just going to do it manually. So again, right click on the transform tool, edit controls, X axis, number, controls, slider control, 0.5. But what I can do is copy the first transform node, select the second one, right click on the name and choose paste settings. This will automatically create and fill up the expressions. Why did we do all that? Well, to be able to move two instances of the same image independently. Next step is to add a mask to each transform node to be able to create the sliding door effect. Drag a rectangle into the nodes window and connect it to the first transform node. Set the width and the height to 1 to cover the whole image. Now, we need to offset the mask half screen to the right and link it to the transform so they can move together. For this, right click on center, choose expression, and here we're going to change the value for the X axis. We're going to type the name of our first transform, so in my case, tr1.center.x for the X axis. And because we want to offset for half a screen, I'm going to add plus 0.5. Enter. And now, I deselect and reselect, you can see that the mask is offset for half a screen. Copy that mask and paste it. Connect it to the TR2. And here, you just need to change TR1 for TR2 or the name of your second transform node. And instead of plus 5, minus. To activate the mask, select the two transform nodes and go to settings and activate apply mask inverted and multiply the mask. Same for this one. To animate our sliding doors with the first transform node selected, right click on the X axis control that we created, choose modify with Anim Curves. We can now switch to the modifiers tab to set our animation. We'll start by adding some easing to our curve, set in point to expo and the out point to scene. Scaling lets us define the direction, scale and starting point of our animation. I'm going to set scale to minus 1.3, offset to 0.5, time scale to 1.3, and time offset to 0.5. Doing the same for the second transform node is going to be easy. As before, I'm going to copy the first node, go to the second transform node, right click on the name, and choose paste settings. As you can see, it added automatically the anim curves and all the settings in the modifiers tab. The only thing that we have left to do is to remove that minus sign. I'm going to set back the viewer to output and play the sequence. Look at how well this is working. Adding more elements to our composition is going to be a painless process, starting by the text. Select the input node, click on the merge icon to add it neatly to the flow. Drag a text tool into the nodes window and connect it to the merge. Format the text you're liking. Let's play it and see how the text is now splitting with the image. If you prefer the text to appear behind the sliding doors, it's really simple. Connect it to the merge. And just like this, the text now is appearing behind the door and you would just need to adapt the animation so it starts earlier. There are so many ways to make the text appear, like having it swipe from the side for example. And in this case, you would apply the exact same animation technique that we use for the transform node. For this one, I rather go with a fade in and we could go to the shading page and animate the opacity. But if you need to apply this effect to more than one element, using this merge node blend control, is going to work perfectly. Right click on blend, choose modify with, anim curves, and switch to the modifiers tab. And I'm just going to set the time scale to 10 and the time offset to 0.1. Let's play it, and this is starting to be pretty nice. We could stop here, or we can step up our game and add some visual effects. Still here, let's start by creating some parallax with a shadow. This will give the impression that the doors are floating above the second clip. Select this merge node, type Ctrl or Shift Space depending if you're on PC or Mac, type shadow and add a drop shadow. In the inspector, I'm going to change the shadow distance to 0.6, the drop angle to minus 100, the drop distance to 0.06, and the blur to 0.4. Next, we're going to add the line that slices the screen just before the split. And I am not talking about the ugly border from the barn door transition. Add the background to the notes window, click on the paint tool, and connect it to the input node. Well, that's an interesting look for sure, and something that you can easily do if you add a transition in front of a single clip. For now, let's fix this by selecting the background node and bringing the alpha to 0. Select the paint node, rename it to line, and click on polyline stroke icon. Add 2 points on the screen, you don't have to be precise right now. Click on the select all icon, right click on one of the points, go to polyline stroke polyline, publish, publish points. You might have to select a different node and go back to the paint node for those points to appear. For point 0, I'll set x to 0.5. Y to 0, for point 1, X to 0.5, and Y to 1. Just like this, we made sure that those points are perfectly centered. Open brush control and choose circular or square as a brush shape. Choose a size, I set mine at 0.004. And to animate this line, open stroke controls, right click on right on, go to modify with, Anim Curves. Switch to the modifiers tab and fill up all those values as you like. I'll set time scale to 4 and time offset to 0.26 to match the opening animation. Another one down, last one to go. For our last effect, we're going to make the underlining clip brighten up as the door slide. Select media in 2, make some space, type Ctrl or Shift space, and type corrector, C-O-R-R, add a color corrector, and in inspector, I'm going to choose brightness among the numerous ways to darken an image. Once again, we're going to use an anim curve by doing a right click on the name, modify with, anim curves. Switch to the modifiers tab, and once again, adjust all those values as you see fit. I'll set scale to 0.5, offset to minus 0.5, time scale to 2.3, and time offset to 0.5. It takes some time getting used to how this control behaves depending on what effects you want to get, so take the time and experiment with them. Our transition is now complete and we just need to make a template out of it. Making a basic template that you can use in the edit page is pretty simple. I am going to show you quickly the specifics for this template, but if you like more detailed information, we do have dedicated tutorials and you'll find links in the description. They both have chapters that you can use to jump to the part that you need. You need to select all your nodes except both media in and the media out. This is actually a very important step as the order of selection will define the order in which all those different controls will appear in your template. Before I select my node, I see that I forgot to rename this merge node, which is our input 2, and I'm going to make sure that I'm setting first input, input 2, and output, then text, line, and drop shadow. I can then select all the other nodes except media in 1 and 2 and the media out. I'll make sure that we have everything that we need selected. Right click, go to macro, create macro. In this list, the most important is to make sure that for input, I have background selected. For the input 2, I have as well background selected. And for the output, output. Otherwise, just select all the controls that you want to access in the edit page. Once you are done, give it a name. I'll name mine, for example, floating doors. And click on File. And choose Save as Group if you want to be able to edit it in Fusion later on. Go to the Fusion folder and choose Templates, Edit, Transitions, and click Save. Close. And after restarting DaVinci Resolve, your template will appear in the edit page. And I have here a version of this transition that I can add then to anything and customize in the inspector. gonna do something like this. Up. I can then change the color of the text, color of the line, and different settings. Let's do this. And there you go. You have a swipe into transition customizable that you can extend with your own features. If you like this video, leave a thumbs up and click on that bell to be notified of our future tutorials. And we'll see you in the next video. See ya!